There are scholarships available for anyone that wants to go abroad to study. But there are different types of
people. Oh, wow.
Different kinds of people.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I understand.
Yeah.
Get your viral and pen and paper. Get your pen and paper and jot things down.
Today I want to share with you and everyone the whole I'll call it a hidden secret about getting admission and scholarship abroad. Because a lot of people don't know about this, and this is why it's almost like we're growing like preachers from from page to page. So we'll be talking about how to get admission and scholarship abroad.
Yeah.
So for example, I'm in Canada today, but I came to Canada originally as a student, as an international student. And when I was about setting out on that journey, the first thing that came to my mind is what we come to anybody's mind. Oh, you want to go abroad to study? Then get an agent, right? Like, go to an agent. And I was like, yeah, I got it all covered. I'm a dentist. I was practicing in Nigeria, so it wasn't a problem. So then I went to different agents, about four of them, in Lagos particularly. And I kept hearing one thing from them. There is no scholarship. There is no scholarship. There is no scholarship. It's like they can help you get admission, but no scholarship. So when I started hearing that there is no scholarship from these agents, let me say I was tempted to believe it. And I went ahead. I signed up with one of the agents. They actually didn't run away with my money. they were able to get me admission. Oh. Now, this is where the problem started. The admission I was giving was going to cost me about $50,000 in tuition alone, and of course I then have to foot my living expenses and all that. And I'm like, so when I saw that, unfortunately I couldn't claim the admission, right? And that also meant that I had to spend more time. So I was lucky enough, one day still in Lagos, I went somewhere, and there was this man that I went, entered his office. I saw the Canadian flag just on his table. And because I've been wanting to go to Canada to study, I was curious. Hey, why do you have Canadian flag here? You know, that was like a strange item in the room. And then he explained how he is a Canadian citizen. He went to Canada to study, went on scholarships. So, of course, it's like he was hitting all the right things that I really wanted to hear. And I was curious. I was like, hey, can you give me the link and give me the link so that I can apply, right? And the man was like, see, girl, go online and search these things out. But I can understand. He's an older person. He's like something years plus. And probably when he did this thing, it was like more than 20 years ago, right? But I took that advice. I went online. It took me time. It took me close to 2 years trying to research, trying to search for scholarships, until I was able to crack the code. This is now the code that we're sharing with people all over the world, which is that there are scholarships available for anyone that wants to go abroad to study. There are scholarships abroad. That's the number one tip I want somebody to take away from here, because a lot of these agents, they repeat it over and over to a prospective student that there's no scholarship. So sometimes you just get into the head. Now, the number two point is that there are different types of scholarship for different kinds of people. And people can actually get scholarship irrespective of their grade. For me, I think this is something that can save somebody today, because some people feel that, like, oh, I have third class, there's nothing for me. You know, I have two, there's nothing for me. Scholarship is for people with first class. Even some first class people don't get scholarship, right? Scholarship is not only giving based on grade.
Oh, yeah.
They literally consider other things like the quality of your CV, your community engagement, if you have ever volunteered before. In fact, some scholarships are not even based on any of these things. Let's say you may see a scholarship for a female, you know, for females. So just being a woman, you're already qualified. You may see a scholarship that is sport oriented. you know. So there are different types of kinds of people.
Oh wow, yeah, I understand.
Yeah, like somebody can get full scholarship, partial scholarship, and my favorite, invincible scholarship. So like a place like Canada, right?
Yeah.
Okay, for example, some of my clients have been able to get MBA with for like 5,000 something Canadian dollars a year. MBA, and these are good schools. You see the point? So now the point is that the regular MBA may just be like $1,000 and higher, right? There are schools that can actually give you very, very low tuition. So for example, we have software that we introduced to our clients. This software helps you to search for the different schools that offer your program and then rank them based on their school fees, so that outrightly you can pick the three schools, for example, that have the lowest tuition for the course you want to study.
Fantastic. So I'm going to ask this question. Somebody says, I have a second class lower with masters from the UK. What's the best route to take?
Yeah, so it depends on the person's master's grade, for example. So I'm going to just make a scenario. So if this person's master grade is high, they can actually proceed to PhD, right?
Oh yeah.
If this person say did a course-based master's, they may be able to do like a research-based master's, which is a different type of master's that focuses on research. And most times, this kind of programs are on full scholarship, right? Now, since this person said they have masters, they also qualify for the express entry. They can. My focus today is not about immigration. I mentioned the immigration component as an advantage or as benefit that I know some people want that, and I know some that will be a question in some people's mind.
Okay, so this one says, is that for you to study abroad, you must have up to 10 million naira in your account? Is that the truth?
It's not the truth. Actually, somebody can go abroad to study with a budget range from $0 to as much as $100 or $100,000, depending on how much you want to spend. For example, all the schools I've been to in abroad, it was all on free scholarship. So I didn't have to pay a dime from my pocket,
cool,
right? So that's why I keep saying that scholarship exists, and these scholarships are not like different people can get scholarships irrespective of their grade. The type of scholarship everybody is going to get eventually is going to differ.
What is the most recommended specialization in the field of economics?
That's a very, very academic question.
To get a visa, wouldn't one need to have up to 10 million naira? No, you've answered that question already.
Yes. And people that get scholarship, actually, their school is able to provide them with proof of funds. So, when a school is giving you scholarship, right, they give you a letter so that person submits that letter to the embassy instead of their own account.
Okay, so this one says, how can my sister in Ukraine, okay, it says, please, how can my sister in Ukraine come over to Canada to do a master's or permanent residence or work permit? We are so confused.
Actually, there's a very great answer for that, which is we have this is more like an info session where we just touch on like the major points that people should take away. But we have a very, very detailed webinar. Very detailed webinar, yes. And the webinar is free that people can actually attend to get started for anyone. Even though I don't want them to leave the video right now because we are still talking, but the link is on my bio actually. So, do you want us to talk about? Tell you direct.
So, Selinda, I've got a few minutes, so go ahead, just continue. I'm enjoying it. This one says, I have two kids, I want to come study. Will they give them visas too?
Yes, students can actually come with their family.
Come
with family. So, I'm still going to use Canada, for example. so because I use a lot of Canadian examples, some people feel that we only handle graduate students that are going to Canada. It's not true, in case you are thinking that. It's not true. So we handle people going to different countries, all high-income countries, right? US, Australia, all the high-income countries. But I'm going to use Canada as an example because that's where I've had most of my clients. And rightfully so, because Canada is really giving international students a lot of leverage. So for a student, let's say a student that has children and maybe has a spouse, so when they get the admission, they're able to apply for visa for their children as well. So the only clause there is that you have to show money to take care of your children.
So this one says, can you help people in do you assist other nationalities like Zimbabwe with scholarships?
All English speaking countries. Because and the reason is because myself and my team, we are English speaking, right? So if somebody can hear English, they can take our training. Because what we do is that we train this person to be able to do it themselves. So if they can hear English, then they can take our training. Irrespective of the country. And mostly we focus on like English speaking countries. Another thing somebody can do is if they have a friend that speaks English, the friend can take the training on their behalf.
And that's cool.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So what that means is that, let's say, I always say that don't let more than one person train in a family, right? Because do you really need every member of the family being trained? If I will say, when some people come and they're like, we are two, should two of us register? I'll say, no, who is the most enthusiastic about both of you when it comes to study abroad? Maybe it's a husband and wife, and they'll say, oh, maybe the wife, or maybe the husband, as the case may be. I'll say, let that person take the training, then the person can apply for the rest of the persons in that household, right? So it's actually an empowerment program, if you are to call it that.
Rate of getting admission and scholarship, especially in Canada, after attending your training.
So the success rate depends on the students as well as the lecture, right? One thing I must say is that there are people currently studying in Canada on full scholarship through our training. There are some that were that their trip were held by COVID, but I don't know if you are aware, Canada is allowing them to start from home. Because this is like the biggest of all news. Why other countries were like, oh, students can't travel, and it's like the students are stuck. Canada is allowing students to start their study from home, right? And then they will still qualify for all the benefits of international students because of the COVID matter. So this is like a temporary, modification.
Would you like to mention how much the training is, what time it is, where and how they can actually apply?
So the training, what we do is that for anybody that is interested, right, we first want them to attend our free webinar, because that's where that person is going to understand everything that we do. Yes, everything that we do. The free webinar, right? It's very detailed. Everything that we do, what this process is about, before that person even start talking about money. Because I feel like when we put the money in front, it's like we miss the point. Because the point is not about the money. The point is for this person to be able to achieve their dreams, right? Yeah. So that is what we do.
So let's take the last.
It's online. The training is online. So different countries, people from different locations are able to take it comfortably. Even people that have very, very tight schedule, because we structured our classes for the busy working class.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to ask you the last question. This one says, please, Ma, can I get fully funded scholarship in Canada for Masters in Business courses?
Business there are, course. Yes. Yeah. The person can actually search for yes. There are.
Okay, so it's free funded. Funded.
Fully funded, yes.
All right, so they're saying thank you.
Thank you.
For this opportunity, informative. Thank you. God bless you giving me. I had a great time talking to you.
Thank you.
Great time.
Thank you.
They are going to your DM now.
It's all right.
Thank you guys for listening to this session. Thank you. God bless you.
God bless you.
Bye.